Really, I've been on calls since last year with a few different Zoom calls and having conversations and with talking about football and hearing different women speak about football and the opportunities that they have had in football. And it was, I think, one of the women from the NFL, from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, last summer was speaking. The defensive line coach, and she was on a Zoom call that I was on, and just hearing her speak about that and having that conversation. And for myself, I have a young daughter who plays flag football, and just been in different conversations over the past year, and just thought, you know what, we have a really great opportunity here in the position that we are in at McMaster to maybe put something together to help our women's flag program. And I just thought it would be something good if we could get some hands on deck and some real good buy-in from our head coach and from our athletic department, which they have. I thought, hey, why not put something together and let's try something.
Was it a tough sell to you know, because I had to go through some channels, of course. But was it, I mean, when you brought the idea up, were the people around you fairly receptive to it?
Oh, in a heartbeat. They were like, yeah, let's go make it happen. Let's make it happen. There was not even a hesitation. I think the only thing that came out of it was, why didn't we do this before? Why haven't we done this before? And that was it. It was, okay, love the idea. Let's make it happen. And how can we make it happen? And let's make sure we're doing it the right way. So that was it.
Yeah. So how does it, in a program like this, you come up with the idea, how does it become what it is now? How do the different pieces come to it? Because there is a administrative side to it as well. So how does it kind of become a fully formed apprenticeship program?
You ask a lot of people that know a lot more than you, a lot of questions, and you really bring in a lot of different voices into the room. You know, you go to I'm the offensive coordinator. So you go to coach and you present it to him and he's on board. Then you ask, you know, I ask Claire Arsenault and different people in the athletic department just for their advice and bringing in their thought into it. And as I was starting to build it and reached out to the president of our women's flag football program and our football program there, and bringing their voices into it and how it can build and how it can work. And, you know, then you take all those pieces. And for me, I'm a planner and I like to have everything set up before going ahead and really presenting it to our athletic directors and associate athletic directors and taking it to them. One, and making sure I had everything set up. But I've also learned everything doesn't have to be perfect. Just make sure you have a plan and then ask for people to help you along the way. So I took the skeletons of it together and took it to them and they were receptive of it. And then for myself, it was really working with our equity and inclusion, having that piece brought in to making sure all the pieces would fit together and what it would look like. So long form, bringing everybody else in and their expertise and then picking from that and taking the best parts of everything and then trying to put something together that can really work in our football program and keeping it to build this for not to just be a one-year thing, but actually creating a pipeline for any coaches that come in to be successful.
You know, it's amazing the way the dominoes just started falling, because you heard about, you know, one female football coach, and then all of a sudden there were more and more. And then, you know, you had female officials in football and in basketball. So sometimes it just takes kind of that one domino to fall, and then it becomes, it's not a thing anymore. It's just normal. And it's crazy how quickly it's happened, because it wasn't that long ago when we heard about the first female NFL coach, and it's just kind of spread now. Just, you know, going back to when you played, I mean, it was almost unheard of that you would have had a female coach, and that wasn't that long ago. So it's crazy how quickly things have kind of gone.
Yeah, definitely. I like how you say that long ago. My son is outside and he's like, "Dad, you're ancient. You never played," and da 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 da. But yeah, and I think just listening and having these conversations and those conversations over the past year about inclusion, just having a diverse staff, right, brings in different voices. And even for myself coming up, I didn't see someone that looked like me coaching or as a head coach and doing those things, but why not? Right? So one of the things that I really like with Coach Potasik is, and even for this role, we're not looking for somebody that has experience in X's and O's, because in the end, we do more than that. We're teachers and we're teaching the information and trying to get it across the best way to our players. And even as an offensive coordinator, I give the information to my assistant coaches or to the positional coaches that we work with. And I believe I may not say it the perfect way that player is going to understand it. And because we're teachers, another coach is going to say it differently or relate to that player differently. That's going to get that information to them so that they can perform at their highest level. And just having to understand that, you know what, there is no one way to do things. There's multiple ways to get the information out and to coach. And we are teachers. So hopefully this program can help. They were teachers and bringing different voices in to help teach.
All right. So then for someone that is looking to apply, what kind of qualities? I know, I mean, there's got to be a list there. I know there's a job posting as well on the Marauders website, but what kind of qualities are coaches looking for in their coaches coming in and in this particular program?
For this particular program, we're looking for really two real main things. Strong communicator, right? Being able to really communicate their message. So whatever it is that they want to communicate, making sure they can get it across efficiently and effectively and communicate in the different ways to their players. Someone that can relate to the players, right? And that's on a football level, because I do believe, and even myself as a former player, now as a coach, players just want to know that you care about them getting better, and you care about them holistically. So that's what we're looking for. And someone that also understands, has a really good understanding of the learning process. How do athletes learn? How do individuals learn? How do different players, and how are we going to communicate that, but how do they learn? And not making sure we, for ourselves, making sure we can pass that on to our players so we can hit on those different communication pieces and those different learning styles. So in the end, the X's and O's will be a bonus, but it's that strong communication piece and really understanding that learning process, because we are teachers. And for me, you got to have a love for the game, right? You got to have a love for, and maybe not specific, but a love for the game of sport, because coaching, I think at any level, they'll say, you know, we put in these long hours and we live for when that light bulb comes on, when we can actually see it and live for those game days. But you got to have a love for it and a real good passion for sport and football.
All right, Coach. Thanks so much. It's a great program. We'll see how it unfolds this season. Thanks a lot for joining me.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. And thank you for helping promote this. It's a real great opportunity. And as I would say, I know I'm the one getting the application. Apply, and then apply some more. We really want to set this off and get a pipeline going with this pilot project.